So let's try some of those more complicated situations outside in our code. So I've got Visual Studio Code open again, and what I have here is that example with the grade point average of a lower grade, and you only make the honor roll or dean's list if your grade point average is over 85 and your lowest grade is not below a 70. Whoops, I just realized my comments said were incorrect. I want those to match up. So what I do is I ask somebody to enter their grade point average, and you'll notice I've done a clever little trick here this time. What I've done is when they pass me a value, the input statement always returns a string. So what I've done here is I've actually said when that string comes back, let's convert what's passed back into a float, into a number, so that I can compare it to a number in my code later. So this is called nesting functions. It's something you might see occasionally in your code, and it can be useful. If you find it confusing, you could just convert the GPA to a float afterwards, but it is possible to nest functions inside each other and do it all in one line. There's a trade-off here between less lines of code and more confusing for someone to read. So I leave it to you whether you want to do it that way or this would be the alternative. Or I can have one way, one the other, and you can decide which you prefer. I could just say, go ask for the lowest grade and then convert that into a float. So both of those achieve the same thing. Because the input function returns a string, I need to convert it to a number before I start treating it as a number. So these are two different ways to convert it to a number, whichever you prefer. All right, now we go ahead and we run that code. And so we call Python and we say, let's call the using and.python. So what I've done here, at the moment I have a nested if statement, one inside the other, and says what was your grade point average, as long as it's nice high grade and my lowest grade was above 70%, then I made the honor roll. So it's checked my GPA. If my GPA met the requirements, then it checks to see what my lowest grade was. And if my lowest grade met that requirement, it said I made the honor roll. But in this case, I could also have combined the two together by saying, really, to make the honor roll, there's just two conditions that you have to meet. The GPA has to be at least 85%, and your lowest grade has to be at least 70%. So this will execute the same way in terms of logic. My grade point average in this case, let's say, assume I have a nice 90% average and my lowest grade was an 86, then I made the honor roll. I should, of course, try a couple of other combinations. What if I have a GPA of 80 and my lowest grade was 80? Aha, it does not say I make the honor roll. So again, I need to test all the combinations and make sure the outputs are as expected. Now, is there any advantage or disadvantage to using the and statement versus nesting ifs? There can be. Let's say you had to calculate the GPA and that was a very complicated calculation that took a lot of time. Then it might be worth just checking their lowest grade and only calculate the GPA if their lowest grade was at least 70%. Because then I'm not wasting time calculating their GPA if their lowest grade wasn't good enough. So in that case, I might use a nested if. But if you're just going to have those values and you're just checking them, then it's simpler to just do it with an and statement. Now, in terms of writing code efficiently, another thing that can save you time and re-execution is using Boolean variables. So we talked about how if you have a very complicated if statement, rather than copying and pasting it to different parts of your code to do different things, we can remember what happened the last time we looked at the if statement with a Boolean variable. So if we take a look here, I've got that same sort of logic of let's check if they make the honor roll by meeting the GPA and grade requirements. But if they do, I'm just going to remember I'm creating a Boolean variable and I'm setting it to true. And again, remember this is true with not true the string. That's a string that has a value true. That would be a string variable. This is a Boolean variable. So there's no quotes around the word true or false. It is case sensitive, lowercase t. That's an easy typo to make. You'll notice it changed to black. The fact it changed to blue, the great thing about using code editors like Visual Studio Code is they give you some colors to try and give you some hints. So I can see true as a keyword that's recognized. So uppercase T for true, no quotes around it. That creates a Boolean variable. And what's neat about that is later in my code, I can say if honor roll is true by just saying if honor roll, you made honor roll. So if I run this code here, let me just run this. Boolean variables. And might assume my grade point average was a 95. Boy, my marks just get better and better every time I test my code. And my lowest grade was an 82. Then it says I made the honor roll. But this time, you'll notice, Ed, my print statement wasn't in the original if statement. It was something that maybe happened later on in my code. So anytime you find yourself copying and pasting the same if statement to a different place, you might want to reconsider and try something like Boolean variables to make your code easier to read. But make sure you do your testing.